Well, hello, I'm Jerry McKee. I'm right here with Sheer Class, and that's what it is, Sheer Class here. And they're celebrating 30 years of being in business. And Kathy Stone's right here. And Kathy, you're working on this beautiful bride right here. Have you seen a lot of different hairstyles in 30 years?
Yes, we have, but it seemed like it always comes back around. You know, big hair and then different styles, different cuts, but these days, you just, whatever you want is what you get.
Well, that's pretty good because my hairstyle changes from the 70s. Remember the 70s?
Yeah, I do. I grew up in the 70s.
Now, did you have the disco look?
Yes, honey. Flybacks.
Now, Kathy, for in 30 years and serving Union County, and that is a really rarity and hair salons because they come and go, and a lot of the new places, you get new people about every month or so, and that's one thing. You've been consistent in 30 years in serving Union County and doing a lot of hairs.
Yeah, it's really been a blessing because over the 30 years, we've met so many people. We've raised so many children in our salon. Now they're having children, bringing their kids to us to do, and it's just amazing how the years fly by, and we've lost a lot of customers during our career here, and Louis Jordan was one of our rocks, too. He was our landlord and everything, and he just passed, too, so we appreciate all they've done for us, too, and but we really are blessed, and me and Gene's been together for really over 30 years. We've been together probably 36 years. Patty's been here 18 or 19 years with us. And we see a lot here, but we try to have a Christian environment here too. So we all are Christians and big in our churches. But we love our customers, and I think they love us. Oh, they wouldn't put up with us for 30 years.
Well, I got to ask you this. You know, when people come into their hair to get relaxed, do you hear a lot of stories?
Sometimes we do. Yeah, you know, they say a hairdresser is like a bartender, a psychiatrist, and a doctor, and a hairdresser. So we all combined into one.
And but what you do besides what the bartender and the rest of them do is that you make them look good and feel good about themselves.
Yeah, we are hands-on for sure. We've got our hands on them a lot more than doctors do, but we don't get their pay.
Yeah. Well, let's bless and bride right here. What is your name?
Brenda Williams.
And Brenda, are you getting married, I understand?
Yes, sir. Tomorrow at 5 o'clock.
Tomorrow at 5 o'clock. Well, you look lovely. She did a great job on your hair.
She always does.
And how long have you been with us, Brenda?
Since they started. And I was their supervisor at
A sweater mail before we started.
Wow, flashbacks. And y'all going to turn around and tell how old you are before you know it. And that's only been about 2 years ago, right?
Oh, sure. Uh-huh.
And our motto when we opened was, our future's so bright, we got to wear shades. That was a song back then. So we all got our big sunglasses on. You got to get a shot of us with them on before you leave.
Got to do that. Yeah. And also at J&E Freelance Media Service, my wife comes here a lot and gets her hair done. And we like to present you this plaque here also, celebrating your 30 years.
Oh, sweet. Oh, thank you. You look, Jeannie.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Let Jeanne answer some of
the
questions.
Now, Jeanne, let me ask you this. Yes. Y'all been, doing here 36 years?
Well, we've been together 36 years. We worked at A Sweater with Miss Brenda before we started doing hair. Yeah, we worked in Spartanburg doing hair, and then we opened up here 30 years ago.
Wow. Now, let me ask you, did you have the 70s hair look too?
Oh, yes. The bigger the hair, the closer to Jesus.
That's good. Yeah, but now I know that... I bet you two together is a lot of fun.
Yes, it is. It's a different kind of fun now since we got saved many years ago. But, yes, we've always had fun.
Well, you know, because you're being saved doesn't mean that you can't have fun,
that's right?
Because we have fun.
Yeah.
Right. I'm a pastor, and and believe me, Edna probably told you some horror stories, me scaring her and stuff, things. But in this type of business, some people come in with hair that they've tried to do themselves.
Yes.
And you come to the rescue. Have you seen anything like that?
Sure, we have. We've seen a lot over the years. Of course, we've probably had to correct some of our own over the years, too.
Now, what are some of the tips that you can give someone that's maybe in a hurry, they don't have time to come here right then, and just something simple that would help them get through their hair day, at least for that day, until they come to you?
Okay, well, if you need a bang trim, most people trim their own bangs and they wind up cutting them way too short. So if you need a bang trim, pull it down to the dip of your nose, right here where you feel the dip, and then trim underneath. That way when they bounce up, they won't be up here like Buster Brown. They'll still be, real pretty bangs on top. That would be one thing.
If they're wet when you cut them, they'll stretch more, and they will dry up when they dry.
Yes, yes.
So my look here in this right here is they need to come to you to cut the bangs, because if I would cut my bangs, one eye going up, one eye going down, mine would be totally crooked. Have y'all seen any crooked ones like that?
Oh, yes, yes. Real short ones, real crooked.
The little children used to tell us when their bangs that was trying to let them grow out, they'd say, well, just cut them off. Just cut them off. I said, well, honey, you can't just cut them off. They got to grow out. They didn't understand that.
We see videos and pictures of little children decide that they want to cut little brother's hair or their own hair. Have y'all had to correct any?
Oh, yes, yeah. Yes. Some we can doctor up, but some have to grow out on their own. Yeah.
I can imagine. And it's funny, too, isn't it?
Yes, it's so funny. It's sweet.
It is. And I think all parents need to put those scissors up from the kids, because that's going to happen, isn't it?
Yes, definitely. Even the little kid scissors, well, they'll find a way to cut if they want it cut.
Yeah. Okay, I got to ask you this question, too. Have you had anybody, especially children like it, to bring a doll in for you to cut their hair?
Yeah, we've pretended on dogs and dolls and whatever that'll get them to sit still. We go right along with it, yeah.
Honey, I even had one little girl. I let her actually cut on her daddy's hair so she would sit still enough for me to cut her hair.
Well, that's two hair.
Miss Ann Jordan.
And that's two haircuts in one, isn't it?
Yeah. And we've got mannequin heads in the back room back there. And a lot of times kids will say, what is that up there? What is that up there? And we tell them that's what happens to customers that don't be still.
That's funny.
Yeah, it is.
Now, what got your start into wanting to fix hair?
We were working at a sweater looking
sewing.
For a way out.
And I said, there's got to be something else. I said, I think I want to do hair. And so,
and I was already cutting, like, after work and stuff on the side, doing family, and then it went to friends. And so we started going to school. And
went to school at night, worked during the day for 9 months? 15 months.
Wow. And, you know, a lot of people think, oh, I want to get into hair, and I just start cutting hair. It's not that easy, is it?
It's not. I told somebody the other day when we first started, we knew that we wanted to do hair but didn't have a clue about how to run a business. But thank God he has saw us through, and here we are 30 years later. Yeah.
Well, I know that people try to color their own hair and really thinks that they can look on the box and said, oh, how beautiful, I will look just like that. I know I would like to look like so many people in the boxes, but they really don't look and see that it doesn't match some things that y'all see. What are some of the things you see as far as color goes that you're looking at a person's hair?
As far as when somebody does their own, you mean with the box?
Oh, right. Not that they need to come to let you do it.
Their hair will be orange or brassy or... they'll think it's going to be brown and it'll be black. You can't go by what the box says when you buy color like that.
Right.
You need the color wheel and all to compare it to.
And you have to realize what shade your hair is to start with, too. You know, they don't take that into account. They just think you can take any color hair and make it the color that's on the box, and it don't happen that way.
Well, the people's hair is totally different, and they don't realize that, like the pH balance and stuff like that, which can affect the color, right?
Oh, yes, and the water that you shampoo with and the shampoo that you use and all of that, yes.
So the best thing for them to do is come to share class and let you do
let
them.
Professionals.
Professionals doing it. Professional for 30 years right here. And tell people where you're at.
We are at 432 North Duncan Bypass, Suite D. It's a round back. We just tell everybody to come to Dr. Bark's dentist office and hang a right.
Now, Miss Patty over there has been doing hair actually longer than we have. And she just joined us, like 19. I said, 19 years ago. Mm-hmm. So she may have some comments for you, too.
I'm going to go over there and talk to Patty here in a moment. And also, Betty Jo Taylor's in the, her hair is dry now. She didn't want me to take it when her hair was wet. So her husband can be able to see how pretty she is.
Yeah.
Well, thank both of y'all, and thank you for a great, great business here. Union County
is proud. Thank you.
Well, it's being a family-owned business, and it's not all easy, is it?
No, not all the time, but we make it work.
Well, y'all look like a fun
it's
group right here.
It's been a blessing
here.
To us,
yes,
though.
It has. To God be all the glory, yes.
Amen. And, you know, I would come in and get my hair cut, but my wife forbids me to come because she says I might hear some of the stories she's telling about me.
Oh, okay.
We don't tell secrets.
Oh, okay.
What happens at Sheer Class stays at Sheer Class.
Well, thank both of y'all. Thank you. Well, you've heard from the other two ladies here, and they said this lady here has been cutting hair for a long time, Patty Rice. How long have you been cutting hair?
40 years.
40 years, wow. Now, have you had all kind of hairstyles also?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
I always refer back to the 70s because that big old, you know, afros and different things.
Teasing hairdos, oh yeah.
Yeah. Now, this is Betty Jo right here in front of me. Now, Betty Jo, did you ever have one of those hairdos in the 70s?
Of course.
Did you ever have a beehive?
No, I did not.
What about you, Patty? You had a beehive?
I did one every prom. Yeah, I had a beehive. When I had the prom time, I had one, yes.
Well, I know my mother and aunt, and they had the real high ones. And I noticed they put toilet paper around them before they went to bed.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you do that?
Well, it's supposed to save your hairdo, but I don't know if that's probably an old wives' tale or some kind, you know.
I
used to see my mom go through the house with toilet paper trailing through the den. So it was a sight to see.
Now, Patty, what are some hints that you can give some people to taking care of their hair?
Well, just use a good shampoo. I don't know. Just
they just need to come to you, right?
Well, yeah.
Come to Sure Class.
Sure. Yeah, we take care of everybody.
That's true. And have you heard some great stories? I know you can't tell, but have you heard some great stories?
I've heard things I didn't want to hear, and I have things that was okay, but yeah, you have. You know, sometimes it's like you put your hands on their shoulders, and they just want to vent and tell you things.
And whether you want to listen, know it or not, right?
Well, you know what? Ever since I've been doing hair, I always try to put myself in this seat and be treated like I want to be treated. And if somebody needs to talk to me, then I like to know that I took time to listen to them. Because you never know when you might be helping somebody.
That's true. The words you can say are something kind. And besides that, you make them look great when they leave here.
We try to. I try to make them look as beautiful as I can.
And someone having a bad day or even feeling bad, and they come here and, you know, you change their appearance and like that, it makes them feel good, doesn't it?
That makes my day. That makes my day.
Have you ever seen when you're doing someone's hair and you just say, wow, did I do that? And it's the wow.
Yeah, I have. I really have. I'm proud of myself.
Well, you should be.
And
I know with the social media and all the Facebook pages and all that stuff there, and you look on there and you say, I did that hair.
Oh, yeah. Makes you feel good.
Yeah.
It does.
Yeah, because it's people just love looking good about yourself.
All of us, we always take pride in what we do. I mean, we do. You know, we want people to be happy and satisfied when they walk out.
Well, I know my wife is. She comes here a lot.
Family here.
And that makes it different, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Big difference.
Well, I've been into commercial hair places, and it's not like that because you might go there one month. Next month, one of your family members be missing.
True.
They go through a lot of people.
But, you know, we have people that just love to come in and sit and talk to us. I mean, not even have an appointment. Just to come in and hang out. We've had people tell us it makes them feel better.
Well, you know what you need to do? You remember the Snoopy's cartoons where she'd hang out the sign, Lucy Wood, 5 cent psychiatrist? Well, maybe y'all need to hang that sign out.
Well, I don't know about that. I'd have to think about that a little bit.
Yeah. Well, maybe, you know, you can get Betty Jo get some advice, because I know that she does a lot of work, and her husband comes here too, right?
Get rid of stress on her when she comes in here. I make her feel better before she leaves.
Well, Betty Jo, how long have you been coming here?
Probably 5 or 6 years.
Well, they do a good job, right?
I hope so, yes.
Well, they do, because you look pretty all the time every time I've seen you in pictures anywhere. So.
Thank you.
Well, both of you. Well, thank you, Patty, for talking with me, and happy anniversary.
Thank you very much.
Well, I'm Jerry McKee, right here at SureClass, celebrating their 30 years being in business. Now, you've seen this lady beside me that Kathy had been working on, and she really did a great job, and she's going to get married. Now, who are you getting married to?
Doc Henderson.
Wait a minute. Did this lady just transform into a beautiful princess in front of your eyes?
Yeah, it sure did.
All right. And I tell you, and you're getting married tomorrow?
5 o'clock.
5 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. 5 o'clock tomorrow. So if you see pictures of these beautiful, beautiful couple right here, you'll know that they came to SureClass. She got turned into a princess, which she probably already was, wasn't she?
Yeah.
And looking beautiful. And congratulations on both of you, and may God bless your marriage and wedding, and God bless both of you.
Thank you so much.
Our future's so bright, we gotta wear shades.
Woohoo!